mirror to the future. Or so a friend once said to me. I did not believe it.
Hi guys, Sai here to tell you why you need to avoid Eisenhorn Xenos by Pixel Hero Games. I've never read the books to compare the story, and I'm sure the way it was heavily narrated in the lead character's head that it must have a heavy resemblance. For those that don't know what it is, you play an Inquisitor called Eisenhorn, and there is a conspiracy going on. It sets itself up straight away with the base you are located in overrun by some sort of zombies, I guess. Traitors of some kind, and chaos is probably involved. It surprised me how linear this game was. Every path you go on leads you to a door, and then you just press A. Or a path that breaks apart, and you press A to jump on it, or A to climb down a ladder. All is pressing A to get by. This felt like the easiest QuickTime events ever devised in a labyrinth of only one direction to go in. Now bear with me, the narration going on, for the most part, is pretty good.
In every direction, rows and rows of ice berths ranged down the smooth basalt chambers. It was like walking into the Imperium's grandest mall.
It really gets you inside the character and what you're thinking and sets the mood of the entire game. The issue is everything else surrounding you. Sure, it's passably 40k Imperium scenery, but it's also very uninspired. By that, I mean, nothing seems like a real building. Just walkways to rooms with boxes and doors. No real sense that the world is lived in or has any purpose. This is something that is easily overlooked in gaming, and it really shouldn't be. It's why games like Skyrim get such praise. The setting for Eisenhorn is very noir. It takes the detective dark corner angle and really runs with it. Obviously this is a setting choice, but it doesn't work that great without proper mood lighting. It's a very black canvas. Now onto the absolute worst part, the combat system. It reminds me a lot of Devil May Cry or the Arkham games, but it isn't at all that complex. The game constantly drops hints about ways you can do different attacks and stances. What I found, mashing the attack button just auto-kills all the enemies, no problem. They all just wait around and line up one by one to be taken out. This is like the worst choreographed fight scene ever. Seriously, after my first two fights, I was ready to put the pad down. A short time into the game, you meet a seemingly capable enemy, but the lines are delivered with little conviction.
Eisenhorn? Gregor, is that you?
The mood looks like a typical horror scene with a bad guy and a gun. Honestly, it felt ushered in from watching Commando.
Let off some steam, Bennett.
I think to get anything from this game, you'd need to be a big fan of the books, and even then, you would probably be horrified with how they've just done the setting. To truly enjoy it, you'd need to somehow be a big fan of the books, and yet, not be bothered with how they mould the source material. Somewhere in there, I can see a good, compelling story, but it's really not worth the effort of wasting so many hours to get so little out of it. I played about an hour and a half of it, and I feel hard done by. Please, give me that time back. This is a 2 out of 10 from me. Sorry, it's not really a game, as a poor experience in everything but the storytelling. Thanks for watching, I'll see you next time.
Admit it, Gregor. You don't want to kill me. You want to join me.